Hello everyone. So here in this problem, we have to solve the equations by Cramer's rule and find out the value of x and y. Now, before starting with the problem, if you'll observe the given equations, then they are not in linear form. And whenever we want to apply Cramer's rule, that time we want the equations in linear form. So first of all, I'll convert the given equations in linear form. So for that, we'll consider 1 upon x minus 2 as A and 1 upon y minus 3 as B. So because of this, the equation number 1 will become 3. Next, 3 into 1 upon x minus 2 is A, so that will become 3A, plus 2 into 1 upon y minus 3, so 1 upon y minus 3 is B, so that will become 2B is equal to 5. So let's say this is equation number 1. Next, the second given equation will become 4. 1 upon x minus 2 is A, so 4A, minus 1 upon y minus 3 is B, so minus B is equal to 3. So this is equation number 2. Now if you'll observe, then we got the equation in linear form. So now let's start with the Cramer's rule. So to apply the Cramer's rule, we have to find out the value of capital D, then dA and dB by using Saru's rule. So first of all, I'll apply Saru's rule to find out D, dA and dB. So therefore, D is nothing but determinant of coefficient of variables. So here the variables are A and B. So D will be the determinant of coefficient of A and B. So here the coefficient of A is 3 and 4. So 3, 4, and the coefficient of B is 2 and minus 1. So the determinant of these four elements will be, or 2 by 2 order matrix will be 3 into minus 3, that is minus 3, middle sign is minus, and 4 into 2, that is 8. So we'll get minus of 11. Next, let's find out the value of dA. So dA is nothing but the determinant of constants and coefficient of B. So here the constants are 5 and 3. So I'll write it down, 5, 3, and the coefficient of B are 2 and minus 1. Now friends, here you can remember one more trick, that whenever you want to find out dA, so that time you have to hide the coefficients of A. So in the determinant D, or in the matrix D, we were having the four elements 3, 4 and 2 minus 1, where 3 and 4 were the coefficients of A and 2 and minus 1 coefficients of B. So when we want dA, we'll hide the coefficient of A. So here the coefficient of A are 3 and 4, so we'll hide this 3 and 4. And in place of this, we'll replace the elements by the constant. So here the constants are 5 and 3. So I have replaced it by 5 and 3. So by that you can get the determinant dA. So by multiplying here, we'll get 5 into minus 1, that is minus 5, minus 3 to the 6. So again we got minus of 11. Next, let's find out dB. So for dB, I'll again use the same trick. I'll hide the elements of B, that is 2 and minus 1. So my first column will be 3 and 4, and instead of this 2 and minus 1, I replace it by the constant, so that is nothing but 5 and 3. So I'll get 3, 4 and 5, 3. So therefore dB is equal to 3, 4 and 5, 3. Next, so by solving this, here we'll get 3 3s are 9, minus 5 4s are 20. So 9 minus 20 is minus 11. So we got the value of DB as minus 11. So we got the values of DA and DB. Now let's apply the Cramer's rule to find out the values of A and B. So therefore, here I'll say by Cramer's rule, we'll get A as, the formula of Cramer's rule is DA upon D, and we'll get B by the formula DB upon D. So here the value of DA is minus 11 and value of D is minus 11. So here we'll get minus 11 upon minus 11, and which is nothing but 1. Similar, the value of DB is minus 11 and the value of D is also minus 11. So again we'll get 1. It means we got values of A and B as 1. But if you'll observe the question, then in the question we have the variables X and Y. It means by Cramer's rule we have to find out the value of X and Y. So here we got the value of A and B, and we have considered that 1 upon X minus 2 is A and 1 upon Y minus 3 is B. So now I'll replace the A and B by the values of A and B. So here we'll get, so here I'll say, but A is 1 upon X minus 2 and B is 1 upon Y minus 3. So therefore, here we'll get A is 1 is equal to 1 upon X minus 2 and B is equal to, or here I'll say 1. So 1 is equal to 1 upon Y minus 3. So this will become, by cross multiplication, X minus 2 equal to 1 and Y minus 3 is equal to 1. So here we'll get X as 1 plus 2, that is 3, and Y as 1 plus 3, that is 4. So here we got the value of X and Y as 3 and 4. So we'll write down the solution set. Therefore, the solution set is always written inside the curly brackets, and the values of X and Y are 3, 4. So we have solved the given equations by Cramer's rule, and we got the value of X and Y as 3 and 4. Thank you.